Hello everyone, Satam here from Alchemist Academy. Today we will do our webinar on dictations. Dictations is one of the most important things you need to do to ace your paper if you're aiming for 79, 65 or 50. Does not matter what's your desired score, you have to have dictations. Absolutely correct. Now, dictations is the last section in your listening and it is one of the most important item types for listening as well as your writing scores. So dictations is really important because they carry almost 25% of your listening scores and they carry almost 23% of your writing scores. Now this percentage is just based on the minimal number of questions that you get in the dictations. Don't be extremely fixated with the percentage. What I do want you to understand is 25% means like one quarter. So irrespective of how many questions you have, what is the length of a dictation, you need to understand that a quarter of your listening score is inside dictation. So if you're aiming for a really high score, you're aiming for a perfect 90, 79 or 65, you have to have your dictations absolutely correct. This percentage can change based on the number of questions, based on the number of words in the dictations. However, the key idea is it carries a quarter of the marks. I have to get my dictations absolutely correct. Now, before we get into how to make sure that we do a dictations very carefully, I'd like you to go through something which is in the Pearson's guideline. All right. Now, Pearson's scoring guide says that when you look at the marking of your dictation, how do we give you a score? So Pearson says that first of all, the scores are going towards listening and writing. Second of all, we will give you one mark for each correct word that is spelled correctly. This is very important. The word not only has to be correct, but also the spelling has to be right. Okay, you'll end up getting zero if there is an incorrect word or there is a misspelled word. All right, so let's have a look in this example. Let's have a look in this, what we can do. If you move a little bit forward, like if you move into the next slide, we will be able to look at the marking criteria of the dictations. So I'll give an example with the slides. So going ahead, if you look at this, this says, this is a sentence. This is a real exam question which says that I have a seminar in an hour and I haven't had the time to prepare. Okay, fair enough. How many words are here? There's about 16 words. Now following the Pearson scoring guide, I should be getting at least plus one for every word. If this is the question and I write it exactly like this. So I should have had 16 marks, but in reality, you'd end up getting at least 17 marks. The reason being you get 0.5 for the capital letter here and you get 0.5 for the full stop. Now, suppose that's the question and my answer is like this. I have a seminar in an hour and I forgot a word, the time to prepare. Now, Pearson is, when PT is checking your exam, when the computer is checking your answer, it's not going to go at the meaning of the sentence, it's going to go word by word. Now what I mean by that is, when the computer is looking at your scores, remember it says each word spelled correctly and each word has to be correct. So if I was to go by each word of the sentence, that means I and IF are not the same things. I have and IF, yes, grammatically you are correct. But if you compare each word, is it the same thing? Do you see the same things over here? Not really. A and A is correct. Seminar and seminar should be correct, but it's not. There's a typing mistake. You've just misplaced the letters over here. Now, there is no autocorrect in the system. So usually when we are doing dictations, we don't realize, like, are we doing the right thing or not? Usually we feel like, okay, I have done absolutely the right thing. Because when you're under time pressure, you have to do the dictations absolutely correct. And usually we are in a hurry to go to the next question and very likely we may end up making some mistake like that. In and in is correct, and our comma and comma, and I haven't and didn't are not the right words. The word should have been haven't, but I wrote didn't, so it doesn't match. Have and have is right. You didn't write the word had, so you're not going to get the mark for that. Though and though, time and time, two and two, prepare and prepare, and your full stop. Even though, according to you, I've only made two mistakes. If you look at it, you would be like, well, I think I've only made two mistakes, and I should get pretty much 15 or whatever the total score is, 14. However, because of all those mistakes, you landed up only 11 marks. So there are certain rules that I will talk about now to ensure that you get the highest possible score with your dictation. So let's have a look at the rules. Remember, the words should be correct, okay? Now let's look at some of the rules. Now these rules are basically built on Pearson's advice, as well as the Q&A section. There's a section where you can read these things. Now, some of the rules along with dictations, because you're doing an academic paper, very basic, very small rule. You're writing a sentence. When you write a sentence, you start it with a capital letter, you end it with a full stop. So the first rule, always start with a capital letter, end it with a full stop. An example is given here. A very basic feature of computing is counting and calculating. Okay, so if you wrote, let's say if I had a small dictation, I have an exam tomorrow. You wrote the entire dictation in capital letters, each and every word, each and every letter, that straight away be a zero. So don't do that. Make sure it's exactly written. Only the first letter is capital and last letter is full stop. If there are proper nouns in between, like the name of a person, name of a country, like example, James, J has to be capital. Australia, A has to be capital, all right? Bear these things in mind. Number two, please do not have any contractions or expansions from your end. You will write exactly what you hear. What we mean by that is, suppose there's a question. It is a very busy day for the cafe. You do not write this as it's. You remember the previous example. You just saw the first example that I was talking about. I have a seminar in an hour. And IF are not the same thing. So always make sure, because the computer is going word by word, word against word, we do not contract or we don't expand the words. Expansion should not be a problem, but contraction, please don't do that. Now, please make sure that you practice properly. If you have a look at this, a lot of people come and talk to me, and usually when I'm doing the class or at the end of the class, they say, "Sir, Satnam, I'm not really sure if it is don't or do not. How do I differentiate?" Answer to this very simple, guys. Listen. If I say a sentence right now that don't miss this webinar, it's very important. Am I saying do not or don't? That question is for you. You need to understand. Did I say don't or do not? So if you can figure this out, you can definitely expect the real exam to be absolutely fine. So these are the first and foremost basic rules. Let's move on to rule number three, and let's have a look what is there in your rule number three. Rule number three says that according to academic writing, according to the rules of academic writing, because you're doing PTE's academic version of the exam, it says the only thing that we should ideally focus on writing in numbers first thing first is only dates. So for example, if I said my exam is on the 28th of September 2020, or my assessment is due on the 15th of September 2020. 15th. Do you look how the word TH is written over here, just like next to 15, and it hasn't gone up. In the real test also, it won't go up. It has to be down only. But this has to come together. September, the S has to be capital because it's the name of a month. The name of months always begin with a capital letter. And the year has to be written in numbers. Is it clear? So that's one of the basic rules of academic writing. Even if it said my birthday is on the 15th of September 2020, it has to be done exactly the same way. Anniversaries, birthdays, whatever. It doesn't matter. Dates are dates. They have to be written exactly in this format. Okay? When it comes to date, you do not, if it says I have my exam on 15th of June 2020, you know, do not write it as 15062020. That's not accepted. Is it clear? Okay, if you get into the more detailed side of the academic writing, it says that when it comes to single digits, now what are single digits? Anything from 0 up until 9 is to be written in letters. Now what I mean by that is, so for example, let's say there's a sentence which says my nephew is just 6 years old. S-I-X, I cannot write the number 6, I cannot write the number 6, it has to be written in the letters. However, if I've got more than one digit, that means double digits, we usually prefer writing numbers. So if you're looking at a dictation with a double digit, in this case, we are expecting around 298 guests this afternoon. 298 should be written in numbers like that. So let's quickly revise before we move to the next slide. Three basic rules. I begin with a capital letter, I end it with a full stop. Number two, I make sure that I only stick to what I've heard. That means I don't expand it, I don't contract it, I try to write it as accurately as I can. When it talks, when it comes to numbers, the only thing that I write with numbers is dates. The only thing that I should ideally try to put with letters is if they're single digits. If they're more than single digits, preferably numbers is fine. All right, let's move on to rule number four. Rule number four says that when a person is speaking, if there is a silent pause, there will be a comma. So for example, if I was saying the sentence, let's see if you can find this, whether the comma is, where is the comma? Okay. Today, we will do a webinar on dictations. So where do you think the comma is? Now, in this case, you need to understand where is my silent pause. My silent pause is just after the word today. So the way I said, today, we will do a webinar on dictations. So just after the word today. In this case, today, we will learn a few lessons on marketing. So there has to be a comma after the word today. Now, let's see if I was not really sure. What should I do? Should I add the comma? Should I not add the comma? Even if you're not sure, just add the comma. There is no penalty on adding something that's not there. Is it clear? So if you added something that's not there, no one's going to eat you up. It's absolutely fine. And it is just a punctuation. Okay. Moving ahead to the last and the most important rule for dictations, according to me, is focus on phrasing. If you focus on phrases, that means if you focus on the meaning of the dictations, you will be able to get like a good understanding. You'll be able to reproduce it. If I understand something, I will be able to reproduce it. But if my intention is, oh, I need to copy down the words, the speaker has said about 13, 14 words, I need to have them exactly. If you focus on the number of words, I assure you, you will lose track. I can do it, in fact, right now. So for example, if you think that it's all about how fast you can take the dictations, now I'm going to see a dictation right now. I would like you to just try and copy the words. And this is a real exam dictation. It's supposed to be one of the longest dictations of the real test. So the dictation is, even if you use cosmetics for several years, one or more ingredients can still trigger an allergic reaction to your skin. Now, if you think that you've been able to copy the words, I'll give you a few seconds. Let's see if you've been able to come up with all the words. Now, check how many words are there and do comment in the comment section. If you think that you've got the right answer, let's have a look. Well, there's about approximately 20 words. I will say this dictation one more time. Usually when I give this task to most people in the class, I see half of my class with their heads lifted back up and smiling at me like, okay, I missed the whole dictation. That's because they were focusing on the words they didn't understand. If I say it slowly and you focus on understanding, I guarantee you would be able to repeat it. So the dictation is, even if you have used cosmetics for several years, one or more ingredients can still trigger an allergic reaction to your skin. Now, think about it. How much of the sentence did you understand and try to reproduce it again? And you will see that there is a big difference. So, always try to focus on understanding sentences. And now, one very important part of this is understanding where the chunks or the phrases are. Chunks or phrasing comes from the three parts of a sentence, which is called subjects, verbs, objects. So if I say a sentence with no breath, with no pause in between, it would sound very weird. For example, today's class is all about the dictation and we'll do listening. So where's the pause? Like there is no pause, but that would be non-human like, that would be non-native like. Native speakers don't speak like that. Native speakers would say something like this. An old man is sitting on the bench with a tree. An old man, yeah, that's your subject, is sitting on the bench, that's your verb, near the tree, that's your object. If you can focus on the SVO, that is the subject, verb and object approach, I am very sure that you will be able to do dictations properly. So the five rules of dictations, very, very simple. Capital letter, end it with a full stop. Write exactly what you hear. Try to put dates and numbers, single letters, single digits in letters, double digits, we can use numbers. If there is a silent pause, there is a comma. If you focus on phrasing of the sentence, that would be a better output rather than just trying to sync in with the words. Are you clear with that? Now, if we move ahead, the next thing that I always get asked is a few common questions during the class. So most people would be like, well, what if I miss a word? And what if I'm not sure what the word, whether the word is in the plural form or singular form, whether the word is with an apostrophe or without an apostrophe. whether what if I forgot the last part of the dictation. Now these are the most common questions. I'm pretty sure a lot of you do also have these things in your mind. How do you ensure that you don't have mistakes because of these elements? So let's look at the, if this is the problem, let's look at the solutions. The solution is very simple. First of all, you are given an erasable notepad and a pen. Please use that to take notes. Never try it directly on the system, because if you try to do that, usually it confuses you a lot. If you focus on, you know, understanding it, you can definitely reproduce it, as I've said it before. Number two, we should try and use the acronym approach. What is the acronym approach? Let's have a look at an example over here. All right, so let's have a look at what is the acronym approach. Now, the acronym approach simply means that we write the first letter of every word and try to put them in the right order. Let's see, this approach is useful because you won't miss any word. Even if you forgot something, you know that you can, reproduce something. All right, let's have a look.
Food that contains antibiotics provides few or no nutrition values.
Okay, now if you have a look at this, if you have a look at this entire sentence, food that contain antibiotics provide few or no nutrition value. Now let's say if you are doing it along with me and you got confused whether it is nutrition or nutritional, which one of these words is correct? Suppose you're doing a real test and you don't want to lose this mark at all. What do you do to ensure that you get the maximum marks? Let's have a look, but first let's go through this. The first thing first that we should be doing over here is, let's say if I had missed a particular word, let's say if I had missed the word contain. I know that foods that contain, that's what the dictation was. Let's say I missed that word. The first thing that you should have done over here is replace the word contain with something else. Putting an extra word is not going to give you any negative score. So if you miss a word, my answer to that question is very straightforward. If you miss a word, replace it with some other word that makes grammatical sense. I'll give an example right now. My assessment is due on the 14th of September. If you forgot the word assessment and you wrote my assignment is due on the 14th of September, of course you won't get that additional mark, but grammatically it is carrying the right meaning. Number two, if you forgot a major part of the dictation, please write down whatever you remember, because getting some marks out of nothing, getting something is better than nothing. I would just simply say something is better than nothing. I wouldn't want to have no marks at all whatsoever, because every single mark counts. You will never know when you would be lucky enough to even put that part that you know and you could just pass the test and get your desired scores. So never ever ever leave any dictation unanswered. Write whatever you've heard. Coming to this, which addresses your question, in case I am confused whether the word is plural or, you know, apostrophe, or is it singular, or in this case nutritional, what should I do? I don't want to lose the mark. What kind of strategy should I follow that I can cover this and also at the same time minimize my risk of not getting a zero? I'll show you a small trick over here. The trick is very, very simple. The trick is, I am going to just, so the word over here is nutrition, and I'm just going to add the word nutritional, and I'm going to put the word value. When the software is checking your paper, what it's going to do is, it's going to go, okay, food's correct, that's correct, contain antibiotics, provide food, or no, nutrition, that's the right word, not nutritional. There's one more word, so that's value. So the software will still provide you all the marks of this dictation. How many words are here? Let's have a look. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Will I get 10 or 11? Of course, 11. There's a full stop. There's a capital letter. So 11 marks. Now, understand this very, very simply, that you have minimum 3 dictations in the test, correct? Each dictation on an average is about 9 to 10 marks. 3 dictations simply means you're looking at about 27 or 30 marks. So you definitely would want to have that section absolutely correct to have the highest score. Now, we're going to use our Alchemist theory for the demonstration to see how the real scoring system, how does the PT scoring system works, and how does it gives us the marks. I'm going to use this strategy. I'm going to demonstrate with this exact same strategy to see whether we can get good scores or not. Alright, so let's jump onto the Alchemist AI. Let's do a few dictations there. Try those dictations along with me. Try to do them under 60 seconds. Let's see whether you and me, we can get them right or not. Let's try together.
Alright guys, let's get into the listening section. We're in a practice, we're in dictations. We're just going to pick up a set randomly and do it. I'm going to take my loads and see what scores we can get from you.
A massive accumulation of data was converted into a communicable argument.
Okay, so I'm done. I'm going to quickly revise before I hit next. A massive collection of data was converted into a communicable argument. To be very honest, I'm not sure about this word. Was it collection or what was it? But anyway, let's move ahead.
A number of students have some volunteer jobs.
Now, I'm not sure if it is jobs or job. What do I do in this case? In this case, I'll just write both the words to see what scores I get.
A party is thrown in the small meeting room.
Okay. A party is thrown in a small meeting room. Let's go ahead. The last dictation.
A person's education level is closely related to his economic background.
Now, for someone who's not sure about whether how to write persons with an apostrophe or simple, just write both. So in this case, I'm using Grammarly, so of course it's going to spot the mistake here, but let's move ahead. Okay, I've been given 88.13. Why is that? So if you look at this first one, I've only got 11 out of 12. Why is that? A massive accumulation of data was converted into a communicable argument. A mass, collection. Remember I said I was not sure what is this word was. Was it collection or not? So I lost one mark there. A number of students have some volunteer jobs. That's fully correct. A party is thrown in the meeting room. A party is thrown in the small meeting room. If you have a look at this one, if you look at this, I had written both the words jobs and jobs. So the software is only looking at the one that is correct. Okay. A person's education level is closely related to his economic background. Of course, it had to be an apostrophe. But in this case, I had written both the words and yet I got my full marks. So you can use this technique, but make sure that don't use it all the time. And it can have a negative impact as well. So let's get back to our slides and let's see what we have remaining on the slide.
Before I finish this webinar, I've got some important tips for you just to wrap it up and in a very straightforward manner with dictations. Number one, please get into the habit of taking notes. I've seen sometimes students, they type directly on the system. in this webinar, I have given you an example of a big dictation. Imagine you got something like that and you're not prepared with your pen and pad and you're just like thinking, I'm going to start writing. If you are a risk taker, please do not risk it out. You want to risk it out in the practice mode. You risk it out in your Alchemist A, don't risk it out in the real exam. I wouldn't want to spend $400 and lose my money as well as another attempt. Time is valuable. Time is the essence. Time is the most important thing. Number two, please try to master the acronym approach. Acronym approach is very straightforward. Even if you are writing all the words, what do you need to use? You need to use those letters anyway. So if you can master the acronym approach, you will be fine. A word of caution, if your exam is in a day's time or 2 days time or 3 days time, I highly recommend not to use this now. Go and give the test with whatever your preparation is. Because if you're using the acronym approach now, you will end up making a lot of mistakes. This approach takes a fair bit of time to practice. But if you can practice, I guarantee you, you will do very, very, very well in the real test. Number three is for people who find dictations extremely challenging. Sometimes they can be academic words. It can be challenging for anyone. In fact, it could be challenging for me too if it's a dictation full of academic words. If you see some dictations that are extremely hard or some dictations which are full of academic words, one suggestion is just memorize those one or two dictations. You don't need to memorize all the dictations, okay? Just memorize the really difficult ones. It eases you, it gives you the confidence. Just in case if I got this in the test, I will still be fine, okay? Last but not the least, you need to practice with this every single day. This by far is the best and the most accurate AI that you can ever practice with. You can do everything with it at home, be it speaking, writing, reading, listening, and there's no limitations as such. If you really want to improve, you need to make sure that you practice with the Alchemist AI. Last and the most important tip, please focus on understanding the things. Just mugging up, just memorizing is really not going to help you. Until unless you practice, you can memorize 1,000 dictations. The choice is yours. Do you want to memorize 1,000 dictations, go to the test praying to God that I hope I get something from there? Or do you want to practice those many dictations and go in confidently and smash the test like I can do it? So the choice is yours. You are wise, make the right decision. In the end, I would also like to add, if you want to contact me, that's my contact info. You can contact me on our landline, on our office landline, or you can call us on the cell phone. However, if you wish to contact via the email, and if you just want clarification regarding your scorecards, you just want some information whether your scores are doing, like which part you need to focus on, where you need to improve, you can send me an email and I'll make an evaluation of your scorecard. I'll reply to you via the email and give you all the possible suggestion and the recommendations that will help you to ace your score. Lastly, this is for people all around living in Gold Coast. If you're appearing for the PTE test and if you're finding that dictations is something that is not easy for you and you're having a hard time, I would like to invite all of you to come into Alchemist Academy, try the dictations absolutely free of cost on our Alchemist AI with the real exam setup. Boost your confidence here, leave your fear here, and go and ace the test. And for those who have the test in the next 1 or 2 days, I hope that these tips will help you to ace your scores. Good luck with everything. Thank you.